Well, hello there! Welcome once more to Quanchua's Kitchen. And if this is your first time stopping by, I'd like to say a very warm welcome to you. Yes, friends, I'm sharing with you yet another fried rice recipe. This is shrimp fried rice, very delicious. It was a hit with my colleagues in two different jobs. I made this for my last day at work at my former job, and for the very first potluck in my current job, this is what I took. Everybody loved it. So stay tuned, and I really hope you enjoyed it just as much. So to start, we are going to be cooking the rice. So unlike any fried rice recipe I'm sharing with you, we are doing everything from scratch, and I'm taking you through everything. So I cut up half of an onion, and this I am cooking in some avocado oil. I'm just going to let this cook until it sweats up a little bit, and then we'll be adding some curry to this to make some curry rice. So whilst we wait for our onions to cook in the oil, I'm washing my rice. This is 4 cups of rice. I'm going to wash it and let it sit so it can drain most of the moisture before we put it in the oil. So at this point, our rice is well washed, and I'm just putting it in a strainer. Just give it a shake and set it on the bowl so it's able to just give off all the moisture in it, because we'll be toasting this in the oil and you don't want it to have any liquid if you can help it. And now look at the onions. Beautiful, partially caramelized, very soft, and it's a good time for me to add in my curry. Yes, 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 you heard right. We are going to have some curry in this fried rice. And don't think it's not gonna be something good. Trust me, this was a hit. I told you, I took this fried rice to two separate jobs. On my last day at my previous job, yes, I made myself a getaway party. I took food, and my husband actually was like, really, who does that? They are supposed to have a party for you, not you do that. I said, well, they will have something for me, but this is me. I've always taken food to them. And this is gonna be my last day working with them, so I think I should take something. And so I made fried rice, this very same recipe, minus the shrimp. I just took some grilled chicken with it, and it was just a hit with everybody. They love this. And so in my new job, the very first potluck that we had, that was the same thing I took with chicken, not with the shrimp, just chicken, because you never know who has seafood allergy, you know. I want everybody to eat it. And it was just as a hit there too. So I was like, you know what? Why don't I share this on YouTube? I can't be keeping this from my family over there. So anyway, as you saw, I put in the curry, let it cook for about a minute, and then I added in there my rice, which had given off all the water, and I am toasting it. So I'm stirring, but I'm also letting it toast. And so I let it go here. I'm gonna cover it now and let it toast for about, you know, 4 minutes on the very lowest setting. So it's just gonna be when rice is toasty or toasted, it's just beautiful when you cook it that way. It also gives it a chance to absorb the flavors. So I have here my stock. Normally, if I make fried rice, I like to use chicken stock, and that way, you know, it prevents me from adding too much cubes or anything. So I bake chicken in the oven, and that is one huge reason I like to bake my chicken instead of cook it on the grill, because when you grill it, you're gonna miss out on all these juices you could have had if you made it in the oven. And so once the chicken was done, I poured this into a bowl, covered it, and actually let it sit in the fridge. And this is how you get it. All the fat comes to the surface. And look at how much fat I just took, you know, lifted off this broth or stock. And if I was to cook something with it right away, dump it there, I would never ever be able to get all this fat off. So that is one tip for you. Refrigerate it, let it sit, and then, you know, you'll be able to separate the fat from the juices. And so this is all wholesome juice I have sitting. And of course, look at this, look at all that fat. So yes, our rice is toasted now. It's been about 4 to 5 minutes on the very lowest setting, and now I'm just gonna stir. And if you were here with me, or you, if when you try it at home, you feel the difference, because the rice becomes very light that way. I don't know, in my mind I always say because it fried some of the carbs. I don't know if you have a better theory to this, a better way to explain this, please comment below and educate us. But that's what I've always felt as a little girl. Whenever I used to make rice and toast it, I always felt like I just fried some of the carbs off. I know, not very, very scientific, but it stick with me. It makes me happy. Yeah, that's what I'll stick to. So anyway, I've added my broth and I'm adding just a little bit of soy sauce in here. So I tried to show you the soy sauce. I added about maybe 2 to 3 tablespoons, pretty much that's all. And right now I'm just gonna go ahead and add some water, and I'll be cooking the rice, of course, with the broth and some water. It smells good, really, really. All that good broth, like the chicken stock or broth, the pan drippings I should call it rather. You know, of course, the chicken was so well seasoned, so you can only imagine how good it smells and how tasty this rice is going to be at the end. Ah, this is just perfection. This is the perfect recipe. And really, like, I just love to share recipes with you that I have, you know, made for other people, and people truly gave me good feedback. It's not just, I like that fact, you know, and that is mainly one reason ever since I became a content creator, even for since I started Instagram. I've always liked to share my food, but I love to share more. I love to have people eat the food and give me feedback. Just because I'm creating a recipe, I'm coming up with a recipe to share with people. And if everybody that has eaten that food I made, you know, really loves it, then I can really stand behind what I'm sharing with you and say, you know, this rice or whatever food I'm sharing the recipe with you will be a hit. And so when I normally say it is a hit, trust me, it is a hit with people for sure. So about 10 minutes into the cooking time, I'm here to cover my rice with some parchment paper just so it cooks thoroughly, evenly, and faster that way. And whilst it's doing that, I have my bag of shrimp here and I am going to peel and get it ready for the fried rice. So I typically like to buy the easy peel shrimp because it makes taking off the peel, of course, as the name says, easy, easy peel, because it's already deveined. And so you just slide, literally just slide the skin right off your shrimp. And of course, I like the fact that it's deveined. I think it looks a lot more beautiful when cooked if you're making fried rice with it, or even if you're going to be making something like coconut shrimp, you know, just perfect, perfect with it. And this actually, if you live in Arizona or wherever you are, probably you could check your local Safeway. I was actually in Safeway yesterday. And I found these. I went to get some more shrimp. I always stock up when it's on sale. And the same size, the same bag is now $10. It's a 2-pound bag, like a $23 value, you know, cost. And now it's just $10. It's just a steal. So if you happen to watch this video before Wednesday, because I know most stores change prices by Wednesday, then get it. So we are just going to go ahead and season our shrimp with some salt and pepper. Very simple seasoning. Nothing major. Remember, it's going to have curry. It also has the stock from that chicken, which is loaded. It had a lot of stuff going on it. So you don't want to overpower your fried rice if you happen to use stock as well. You know, just look at that. And this is pretty much all. So I'm just going to go ahead and add some salt at this point. And I've also added some white pepper. So black pepper, white pepper, and salt is all I'm just going to season or marinate my shrimp in. And then we'll start making our fried rice. So whilst that is going, I have my bag of spring onion or scallions over here. And I have just given it a wash right under running water. And we are going to cut this up. Normally when I make fried rice, I have over the years or months, I should say, because it's quite recent that I stopped putting too many vegetables in my fried rice. I still do put peas and other things sometimes, but I one time made this very simple fried rice for my husband. I had white rice in the fridge one morning. You know, he was going to work. I just got up super early on my day, of course. I hadn't, you know, our meal prep was done, like my first morning home from my days off. And I had rice, I had shrimp, I had some carrots and onions, and I just whipped something together so fast, so quick. And that fried rice was so delicious. Like, my husband, he was like, ooh, that was good. He actually called me from work to say that. And that was a Thursday. Like, if you watch my previous video, I told you about my friend that I normally hang out with on Thursdays. It was a Thursday. I was going to go to her house to hang out. So I went with whatever was left. And she was like, ooh, this is good. You have to make me this. And it was shrimp fried rice too. The same kind of fried rice. But of course, it wasn't carried rice. And that was a hit. And since then, like, seriously, I've gone very simple on my fried rice. Sometimes, you know, less is really, really, really more. So I'm done cutting up the scallion. And right here, I have a ginger. You know, I love, love, love ginger in my fried rice. I can't even stress that enough. Like, I know you're probably rolling your eyes like the way I like to roll my eyes. Because, yes, but I have to say, because you know what? New people keep joining our family, okay? So they need to know. Ginger in fried rice is the bomb. It's the bomb. So please, please do me a favor. If you've never put ginger in your fried rice, do me this one big favor. Try it, especially if you can get freshly grated ginger. Put that in your rice and let me know. Let me know what you think. So anyway, all our vegetable prep is almost done because I'm being lazy. I'm using store-bought carrots today. And of course, our rice at this point is perfectly cooked, perfectly cooked. And normally, you know, to make fried rice, you want people normally would make it with rice, like leftover rice, or you cook your rice way ahead of time, let it cool off before you start. And in this video, because of course, the way I am doing it, I wanted to show you how I made the rice, because this is not just white rice, so I'm taking you through everything. And so this is not going to cool all the way, but it will be a little cool enough by the time we get to add the rice to it. And so here we go, looking for our famous wok. I know a lot of you have been able to buy that, and if you are not subscribed to my channel, do subscribe, because I make it a point to share with my family here stuff, you know, some of my things from my kitchen that are on sale that I know people would love to buy, like this. It was a steal, and a lot of people got it and they are happy. And yes, I've heard from you all about the kitchen and pantry tour, and hopefully I get to do that one of these days pretty soon. I would love to share with you, and hopefully that, you know, answers most of your questions about the pots and pans and storage and everything. So anyway, I put some oil in here. Just about, what, 2 tablespoons of oil just to cook the shrimp. And when it was hot enough, I have introduced in here my shrimp, all of it, all 2 pounds of it in here, you know, and I'm just gonna let it cook until it, you know, you see how the color is changing, it's cooking on that bottom part, and then so I'll be able to turn it, you know, you don't cook shrimp for too long. So this is gonna be cooking for about 3 minutes on each side. And so, like, after 3 minutes, I'm just turning it, and look at that, this cooked beautifully. It is so beautiful, beautiful. And you know, the juices from this shrimp, of course, is going to bring so much flavor, you know. That is why, of course, we Ghanaians especially, we love our Maggi shrimp tablet, our Ongard shrimp, because shrimp brings so much flavor into your food. And this fried rice is not going to be any exception, because it has the shrimp and the juices that it's cooking in. So, you know, it's going to be very, very good. This wok, and the fact that I asked you to subscribe, I only asked you to subscribe, I think I should clarify, because when I make community posts, you can only see my community post if you are subscribed to my channel. And that is where, if I find something, I'm not going to make a video just to tell you to buy something, you know, because by the time I get the video to you, it's probably going to be gone. The sale will be gone. But if I see something at a good price, I quickly make a community post. If I can post a link, I post a link to it in the post. And, you know, it's not bringing me any money. I'm not getting anything from that. But I love the fact that you appreciate the cookware or whatever I use, and you want to get some for yourself. And for me, you know, if it's going to make you guys happy, then I'm happy. So yes, if you can and you're not subscribed, kindly subscribe for things like that. I think it will help. So our shrimp is cooking beautifully, and at this point I am getting my eggs ready. I know I love eggs in my fried rice. It's like I can't take it out of my head. to exclude eggs in my fried rice, I guess. So here are just 3 eggs cracked, and I'm just gonna go ahead and whisk them until perfection. Sometimes I like to just break them into the oil just like that, so you have the 2 parts of the egg, the yolk and the white, so you know it's adding more to the colors, the vibes. It's all up to you. Like I always say, cooking is very much temperamental. You can do as your heart desires, unlike baking where you really have to stick to everything, the whole recipe. And that is why I love to bake, but I love to cook more. You can switch things up anyway, and most of the time you still achieve the desired result. So our shrimp is cooked beautifully. I like it to have a little bit of char. I like it to be very well cooked, as you can see, because I, especially having the kids eat it, I don't want to make any mistakes and have them, you know, eat something that is going to get them sick or worse, deter them from eating it another time. So yes, this is perfectly cooked as I like it. You could cook it a little bit less if you prefer, and just look at that. So beautiful, beautiful. Just like I told you, it's so nice when the shrimp is deveined. I just like how it looks, you know, as opposed to it just being straight, you know, not deveined. I don't know. To me, this is beautiful. So here I have my oil already. I actually just put my carrots. I told you I was going to be lazy today. These carrots, I got a bag of julienne carrots from the supermarket, and that was the very last of it. So I just added that in here, and I think I'm going to need to add a little bit more oil when I add my eggs, because that's not going to be enough for me to fry my egg and also enough for me to cook the whole rice. Yes, the rice, actually the pre-cooked rice has some oil, so that will help. But like you saw, I just had a little bit extra oil in here that I added, and now I've added my egg. So what I like to do is like what you're seeing right now, I push the carrots to the side or whatever vegetable will be in the wok at that point. And then I make my eggs, I scramble my eggs on one part and then mix everything together. Feel free to scramble your eggs in a separate bowl or make it ahead, you know, scramble the eggs first, set it aside before you start with the other vegetables and introduce the eggs in later on. Like I said, with cooking, you can do it whichever way you think works better and you still achieve good results. This is how I felt like doing it today, more like this is what the spirit made me do, you know, and so I went with the flow. So it's scrambling beautifully at this point, and now I think it's good enough for me to just go ahead and stir everything in, because at this point the egg is almost all the way cooked, and this is all the scrambling I can get, and I think it's good enough for me. So I'm going to go ahead and introduce in my grated ginger at this point. Yes, that is the game changer, like really. And almost right away, the smell, you know, the aroma in this house just changed. It just went up a notch. It smells so good. So good. So I've let the carrot cook in here with everything for about 2 minutes in total, and I'm now adding in my pre-cooked rice. Very, very fragrant, very, very delicious, tasty. The aromas, everything perfect, perfect. Because, you know, of course, I told you, from the stock, you get everything, you know. You don't need any seasoning cube in here because it has all the seasoning, all the great taste flavors that you need in your fried rice. And so I'm just going to go ahead and mix this up and look at that beautiful color. Beautiful. Just beautiful. It smells so good. I really hope you're able to try this recipe. You will love it. And so I'm just gonna go ahead and add in the shrimp at this point, of course, making sure I get all the juices to go in the rice, because that is where it belongs, to bring in some more flavors. And at this point, I'm just gonna go ahead and stir that in as well. Just look at that. I know. I know you want a spoonful, and I really hope you try it, because this is gonna be like one of the best recipes that you ever tried. And as always, 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 my scallions go in at the very last end. And that's how I like it. It brings more aroma that way, more texture, more flavor. And as soon as I add my scallions and mix it up, I turn down the flame and this rice is cooked to perfection. There we go. So dear friends, that is how simple, easy, fast it was to whip this up. And it's time for us to sit and enjoy this goodness. This was just really, really a hit. Just look at that. Just look at that. My kids, they love their shrimp. Look at him. Do you see him over there? He started eating the shrimp as I was cooking. He just loves it. And this rice, they really like. So I hope it's a hit with your kids and your entire family, just as it is with mine and everybody that has had it. This is simple, but oh so good. And if you are one who loves your spice, then of course you would want to add a little bit of shiitake to this to give you a kick. And so I'm going to be adding a little bit of Quanchue's Kitchen shiitake for that effect. And I really hope you try this recipe. Thanks for watching. Thanks for doing this with me. I hope it has been fun for you. And if this is your first time here, this is Quanchue's Kitchen, where making simple, wholesome, replicable meals is my passion. And I really hope I get you to stay. And until I come your way next time with something delicious, be loving, be kind, be happy.
Yeah, dear,